I might be going insane. I might have lost my mind, but this project is happening. I have, you know, Monday, I have the rest of today, and then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, basically, to get this done. So I have like 4.5 days. I'm running on about 4 hours of sleep and a whole lot of coffee. I'm gonna make some eggs, and we're gonna make this happen. It's happening.
We're Kaylee and Lindy. Each week on this vlog, we take you behind the scenes as we develop our 2-acre permaculture homestead and grow our own food. Join me this week as I attempt to make a special surprise for Lindy by creating an outdoor kitchen space in only about a few days and with only about $1,000 budget. Join me. I believe we're wild and free. So this week's vlog is going to be a little unique because Lindy is gone. She is on a work trip and I'm on a little mission of my own. So I want to turn this space into an amazing outdoor living and dining space, complete with a little outdoor kitchen area while she's gone. So that means I have about 5 days. I have a budget of about $1,200 to completely renovate this space. I am so excited. This is something that we have been talking about for the longest time, and I know she is going to lose it when she gets home and sees the space completely transformed. But that means I've got to get busy. So we're going to get started right now. We don't have a lot of time. So today's mission is actually to drive into town and brave an IKEA. That shows you really how much I love Lindy, that I'm willing to go to an IKEA. So gonna go to an IKEA because there are some amazing pieces that I need to build the outdoor kitchen quickly and efficiently. Yeah, I was going to like hand build one, but this is just going to make the project so much easier and doable. So that's what we're doing. I'm actually going to enlist the help of my friend Danielle, who's going to teach me how to IKEA properly because it's something I definitely don't know how to do. So I'm gonna head over to her house and then we're gonna get going. Okay, so this is my friend Danielle. If you watched our nursery trip video, she was also in that. She likes to help me shop because I'm terrible at it. Yeah, so very grateful for this. So my IKEA experience is not good. Shortly after we moved here, we had never been to an IKEA, Lindy or I. We walked in and we didn't know what to do. I don't know how else to describe it. We got super overwhelmed and we just left after like 5 minutes. That's my IKEA experience.
You're gonna do the full IKEA experience today. We're gonna go in, we're gonna walk the floors, we're gonna look for things. We might even have a snack. It's gonna be good.
Yes, so very grateful for the help. I do have pieces already picked out from looking online. This will be an experience.
First piece, actually, like right away. So this is the little island, so cute. So it's got the little bar on this side, little shelves over there, and I might add on the little top piece if they have it in stock. Food time. It's crazy. So she was pretty excited about the ice cream cones.
I was so excited. We're gonna finish our day, you know, the right way at IKEA with an ice cream cone. And apparently there are cones, so we're just gonna like lick it out of the cup.
Overall, very successful. Not gonna do it again anytime soon though.
IKEA's like a once a year type of trip. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm glad we were able to get most of it and I'm good not coming back. I think eventually I'll get another one of the low propane burners to add in, but they only had one. And that's okay, we got one and we got the island. That's the main important thing.
Yep.
So it was successful. Thank you for helping me navigate this craziness. Good morning. It's Sunday. Lindy gets home on Friday. Starting to feel the time crunch a little bit. Yesterday, all we did was shopping.
Which is okay because we need to get that out of the way, and that's the worst part. So last night, the dogs were just insane. They don't sleep well when Lindy's away, so we had that whole issue. They just get up all night long, and Paisley hasn't been feeling good. She's just had an upset stomach, so she got up like 3 different times. I had to take her outside, and then at like 4 o'clock in the morning, I roll over in bed and move my hand and it hit something wet. No joke, I put my hand in a pile of vomit that was in my bed. So that's how my day started. I got to do some laundry and strip a whole bed at 4 o'clock in the morning. And then the fireplace, the wood stove, the pellet stove wasn't working again this morning. I have the little bypass cord on it right now. It seems to be working, so it might just be the vacuum pump, which is brand new because we just bought one. Anyways, that's a different story for a different time. While I was laying awake in bed after the dog vomit incident, I'm thinking about every little detail and trying to plan out everything for this space, trying to like make sure I haven't missed anything. And I'm realizing that originally I had planned to do just like rock in the dining, like in the area where the dining table's going. And I realized that's just, it's not going to be the long-term solution that I want it to be. Because like, while yes, I'm doing this on a budget, I want it to have a good long-term effect. Because the rock just, I don't know, it's going to be very, well, rocky. You know, it's just, it's going to be hard to like move chairs or benches, get things level. So I really came to the conclusion that I need to have some sort of decking. Unfortunately, the most affordable option for decking that's going to be like efficient for me to put in and honestly just within my budget is buying decking tiles. And you know who has those? IKEA. IKEA has them. And they're like the only affordable ones. But not the IKEA we went to yesterday. Another IKEA in Portland, even further away. And you know what I'm doing today? I'm going back to IKEA. But not the same one. Not the close one. Close one. The one in Portland. And I might be going insane. I might have lost my mind. But this project is happening. I have, you know, Monday, I wrote the rest of today, and then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, basically, to get this done. So I have like 4.5 days. So I'm having some eggs, real quick breakfast, and then we're gonna get on the road and go to Portland today. But I'm prepared. I have a quart of coffee. I'm ready. We're gonna make it happen. It's gonna be good. Did that sound convincing? It's fine. We're going. We're making it happen.
Okay, we've made it. But we're going to make a quick pit stop right here first. Okay, now we're getting down to business. We're here.
IKEA. Yay!
Part 2. Okay, IKEA trip number 2 complete. Got all the decking tiles. I think this is a good choice. It was a little bit more than I wanted it to be, but I think these are going to hold up really well. So now we gotta get them home, get them installed. Okay, so we just got back and most of the day's gone. The sun's kind of going down. I cannot believe I've wasted 2 days shopping, but it's okay. I pretty much have everything that I need at this point, so I can start in on work. I do have some like work to do tomorrow. So hopefully I'll still be able to squeeze in a couple of minutes to get out here. I think the first thing that I really need to do is start by disassembling that big planter bed, the big concrete planter. I've been emptying the hot tub. It was emptying today while we were out. So the hot tub has been draining, hence the hose. So I can get that moved right away and out of the space. And as soon as I can get the planter disassembled, I can start removing the sod. And I think I will lay down then a weed mat, and hopefully, that will be enough, but I might need a thin layer of sand just to help level those tiles. But I think it's going to be worth it to do it the right way the first time, even though it's going to take a lot more effort. That's okay. We're going to make it happen. We still have 4 days really to get this done. Yikes. Stanley, are you draining the hot tub? That's not gonna work. Thanks for your help. Drop it. Ah, Stanley.
Good morning. It is a glorious morning. It was supposed to be really cold and possibly even snowing, but it's not. It's glorious. And luckily, I stayed up late and did my video editing for the week. So that means I can just jump right in and start on this project. Okay, so I kind of wanted to walk through my design for the space. I should draw it out, but I haven't yet. So it's just in my mind, which is a scary place for it to be. But we have these back stairs, and when you come down the stairs, it basically leads right into our little workshop area, the garage, whatever you want to call it. So right over here is the space that I'm going to be renovating. So this space is going to be where the deck goes. This is going to be basically the dining space. So from pretty much where the hot tub is, like where the planter is, pretty much even all the way back to this other sidewalk is going to be the decking tiles, and this will be the dining area. So then where this planter is right now, that will be gone. So this space right here will again kind of be the deck area, and then the little kitchen area will be underneath the cover, kind of sandwiched right here so that it's in this walkway that we have, this little breezeway area. So it's going to be right here, sandwiched between the breezeway and the deck, so we can work inside when it's raining, be undercover. We have power there. It should be super nice. So then as we move around to the hot tub, is actually going to move over here into this space. The umbrella is going to hopefully sit somewhere in this range, like right in here, because it swings around so it can cover the hot tub or it can cover the dining areas we need. So we have the hot tub right over here and the dining area, which will run right along here. And then kind of coming off of them in this big half circle over here is where I want to make the fire pit area. So that's the plan. I don't know if it's actually gonna turn out like it is in my brain, but that's kind of how I have this space set up in my head. And that's what we're gonna start on today, breaking down that monster right there. So I'm gonna move the hot tub. It's already pretty much drained. Get it out of the way and then start breaking down that big old planter. So a lot of these have already come off. And again, you can see how like split it is here. It's such a cute little planter, but I don't even know how much longer it's gonna hold together. So it's time for it to go. Okay, so I think my plan is just to see if I can like chisel where the mortar is and get these bricks separated out. So that's my plan. I don't know. Let's give it a shot. Okay, for the sake of time, we're gonna try something new. I can't even today. Okay, I'm gonna go get a different sledgehammer now. Little pieces I can still use for urbanite, which we use to basically line our beds with. Okay, hold up. This looks promising here. Yes. Okay. Ooh! Okay. Good. That's good. Okay, that's the best progress I've had so far. Back up and running. do it again.
Move, Stanley. So helpful. Stay over there. I feel strong. I can barely lift the sledgehammer, but you know. Okay, maybe not. I can't really lift these. So, I need you to break. That worked.
By the time they're 40.
I sure don't.
All right, so I've got these pots, which I want to use in the space. So what I want to do is rescue as many plants from here and put them in the pots and then use them in the space. So I don't think this guy's gonna go in this pot. It's just too big. So I'm gonna put him out somewhere else where he can live a better life, where his roots can be happy. So I'm really happy I was able to save as many as I did. And they turned out really good, and I got some little solar lights to stick in them, so I'm happy. But now it's time to get back to work over here, breaking this apart. Today, but I just keep reminding myself how amazing it's going to be once this space is done, how we will enjoy it for so many years, and how excited Lindy is going to be when she sees it. It'll be worth it. Everything that's worth it takes a sacrifice, right? So I'm gonna get this grass done today, if Stanley will stop standing on the shovel and trying to hand me his ball. All right, you guys are loaded up. We're going to the pasture. All right. Bye, Sam. So close, just that little patch left. So I think I'm gonna get all of the grass removed before the sun goes down. Although to be fair, it's hard to tell when that happens sometimes in Washington because it's already dark and cloudy. So maybe it already went down. I don't know. Where did your ball go, Stanley? Where is it? Where is it? Come on, get it. Get your ball. Well, that wasn't a very good effort. Good boy. Well, I made a nice little discovery that pretty much about the bottom third, I'd say, down is pretty much basically just a sand soil mix. So I'm not gonna have to buy sand. So I'm just tossing it out here. I'm going to use it to level with. Perfect. So the other really exciting discovery is this. It's concrete. They put this bed over the concrete. But this is definitely a solid paved surface. I'm so excited to see that. Crazy, the things you find in an old house. I'm gonna call it a night. It's getting dark. My back hurts. I need to be done. I'm really happy with what I got done. Hopefully tomorrow I can finish all the destruction and then start in on construction. Made some good discoveries today though. I'm super excited. So I'm gonna go inside, warm up, have some wine, try to get some work done. Yeah, I'll see y'all in the morning. Good morning. So I woke up to snow. So I don't think I'm going to be doing a lot outside this morning. I do have some work meetings this morning, and of course I have some work that I need to get done inside. So I'm going to focus on doing that. Oh my gosh, it's snowing again. I'm hoping this is going to melt off quickly. I can still get back out here this afternoon and work on this area a little bit more. I guess this is what happens when you try to work on your summer outdoor patio area and it's only February. I'm gonna spend the morning inside, so I'll check in with you later.
The snow has melted, which is good, but it's chilly. So I don't know if I'm going to get the rest of the soil moved today. I might just use today as an office day. I have puppy in my lap down there. And I'm doing a lot of video editing right now because I need to get that done. If you want to see a vlog on Friday, and I know my mom does, so if nobody else, my mom wants to see it. So I need to get that done. So I might just use today as an office day and then really start in heavy again on the project tomorrow. I'm getting a little nervous. It's only Tuesday, but I don't know. I'm still like feeling that time crunch. I think that's the plan for now, at least. It might change. It always changes. Hi, Ida. She's using me for my warmth. She doesn't actually love me, but that's okay. I'll take what I can get. Let's get to work.
Stones we carry, clothes we lived in, all the tales we will tell our children.
I don't know what I was thinking doing this project in February. It is so cold this morning. I think it was like 15 degrees when I woke up. The sun is out though, so hopefully it'll warm up. I can do some inside projects for a little bit and then get back out here in the afternoon. But oh my gosh, it's cold. Everything is frozen, including this hose. It was so frozen I couldn't even wrap it up yesterday because it never warmed up. Oh, Stanley. Stanley, that's not how it goes. Good effort. Okay, well the sun came out a little bit. It's still really cold, but it's about 34 degrees now, I think. So hopefully it's warm enough that I can get the rest of this soil moved. I did try it earlier and it was frozen solid. So I gotta get to work because I have today and tomorrow to get this done and maybe just a few hours on Friday morning. So really I'm down to, 2 days at this point. So I'm getting a little scared, but it's okay. I'm gonna make it happen. I gotta get to work. So here we go.
Oh.
Making some progress. It certainly didn't take long to warm up, that's for sure. Oh my gosh, I already had to change out my base layer. But this is almost done, so I've just got a few more bricks to remove, and then I'm leaving a lot of the soil actually here because I'm going to be able to use it in this space to level both the fire pit area and where the hot tub will go. So I was like, genius, just leave it there, don't move it, duh. So I'm figuring it out, slowly but surely. Is disgusting. Like, this is really disgusting, Stan.
Hey, it's gross.
So now that I've got the bricks out, I'm gonna go ahead and figure out where the fire pit's gonna go and where the hot tub's gonna go. So I need an iced coffee break, and I'm going to go get the rock while I'm at it so I make sure to get it before they close. So I'm going to go do that even though the area isn't quite prepped yet. It's okay, I'd rather just have it here because I think they close at like 4 and it's 4 or 5 and it's already 3:20. So, got the coffee, got the rocks. So I got this red lava rock and I think it's going to be really pretty. I don't normally like lava rock, but I think this is going to look so good with the decking tiles that we got. So 2 yards in Todd, the amazing truck, and he didn't even budge. What a difference compared to us trying to put those stupid pellets for the pellet stove into the old truck. Amazing. Come on, boss up. Come on, boss up. Come on, boss up. Never been down on my luck. So I'm removing this strip of grass right between where the sidewalk ends and the grass is, just so that I can get the weed mat closer to the sidewalk and we don't have grass growing out in between it. Nothing that bothers me more than putting down all that weed mat, spending all the time to lay out the rock, and then you still get grass growing in that little strip between the sidewalk.
So I'm just gonna remove this really quickly, hopefully really quickly. It's getting dark, but oh well, I've got lights, so it'll be fine. Boss up. Come on, boss up. Come on, boss up. Come on, boss up. Never been down on my luck. Boss up. Come on, boss up. Okay, little hiccup. The other roll of weed mat that I thought I had wasn't weed mat, it was screen, like netting screen. Where I have another roll, but I'm just gonna run to the store and get another one. I ran to the store really quick and I was able to get another roll of the weed fabric, so I've got that now. And then while I was there, I also grabbed basically like that plastic edging to kind of help keep the rocks in. It's going to be a bit of a marathon to get this finished. I might be a bit crazy, but I still think I can get this done. I just need to bust it out today and tomorrow. Yeah, that's the plan. So for the new fire pit area, I'm actually disassembling this fire pit because it's directly in front of our gate to get into the garden. Plus it's super close to the propane tank, so moving it further from that. So I'm going to use these stones that are around it, the pavers. This is an old washing machine tub and clearly it's burned through. So I'm just going to use it to gauge the size I need, but we're just going to use the pavers instead to make the, wow, this is falling apart. So obviously we're going to use the pavers instead to make the walls of the fire pit. So I'm going to take this over to make sure I have the size and then start pulling up these pavers. Oh my gosh, I can't believe it. I have a fire pit. So that's done. I think it's like 7 o'clock at night. I don't even know, to be honest. If you've ever wondered what hyperfixation looks like, yep, this is it. I'm exhausted, but I'm really happy with the progress so far. It's like 7:30 at night, so I need to stop. I need to like regroup, have some time to like relax a little. I still need to do chores, take care of the dogs, do some work. So I'm going to call it quits for the night, but I got the first layer of rock laid and I got the fire pit done. So still really good progress for the day, especially since I couldn't start until noon because everything was frozen. So hopefully tomorrow will be better and I'll get it all wrapped up, or at least mostly wrapped up tomorrow, because I have tomorrow and a little bit of time on Friday morning. So I'm really proud. I'm so happy with how it's coming together. But I'm tired, so I'm gonna go take a bath. I'm so sore. That is not what I wanted to wake up to, folks. More snow. Ah, what a week. Snow was definitely not what I wanted to wake up to. I'm going to have to wait for it to melt off in order to do the rest of the groundwork and get the deck laid down. I think I can maybe unload the rest of the rock though, but first I'm gonna go do chores. Hopefully it will warm up a little bit sooner today. It is supposed to get up to about freezing by 10. So we're just gonna make the most of it. We can't choose what nature gives us. We just do what we can with it. So that's what we're gonna do today. So one thing that we've become really purposeful about over the years when we do projects is figuring out where the waste products are going to go. Especially if you're removing things from an area, we used to kind of just like, oh, we'll just put them here for right now, blah, blah, blah.
We try to do that as little as possible now, because what ends up happening is you just have to move that thing from place to place to place. So if we can find a place to like initially put it where it's going to serve a purpose, it's going to just decrease our overall workload, because we're not going to have to like move it again or find another spot for it, or now it's in the way for a different project. So figuring out what to do with those waste resources has been huge for us. For the most part, a lot of resources can just be endlessly recycled, and we have to get in the mindset of like, there is no away. Things don't go away. So finding a way to keep those resources on our property and use them in a way that's going to be productive and beneficial to us is what we try to do. So for instance, all the sand that I'm taking out of here, you know, I've used what I can in this space. Now I'm taking it over wheelbarrow loads at a time to the horse runs on the backside of the barn where they're really divoted and we have a lot of drainage issues. So I'm building that up with the extra sand. We're going to have less drainage issues. We need to level it anyways. So it's great. It's a great way to just use those resources. All the rocks I'm pulling out there, I have like a little rock area where like I toss rocks because we're endlessly finding giant river rocks. So whenever we have rocks, I put them in this area and then I reuse those. And I reuse those as I build our perennial beds. I use them as borders. So lots of uses for these natural resources. I'm going to take that and take it. I'm going to take that wheelbarrow out to the horse barn and keep going. I don't know what Stanley's issue is. I think he lost his ball. Oh, well. I'm sorry. I can't help you with that. You have to go find it yourself. I can't help you. Sorry, buddy. All right. I got it all swept off. Look how great that looks. There's some chunks that I can eventually chisel down, but I'm not too worried about them. It has a nice little border and everything. I cannot believe that was under the bed. It's got those three drainage holes I'll fill with gravel. But look at this space. It's really coming together despite the snow.
Well, the sun has decided to grace us with her presence, which is very nice. So I just got done with my work meeting and now it's time to get back to work. I think I'm going to try to lay out the border around the fire pit area and then get the rest of that rock laid, go back to the sand and gravel place, grab the crushed rock, get the weed mat laid, and then get the crushed rock down, and then get the deck put on. Easy peasy. I mean, no problem at all. I'm fine. Okay, deep breaths. Deep breaths. We can do this. Here we go.
So how this works is it has this little lip, which will go on the inside. So it'll go this way to hold the rock in. And then these help secure it to the ground. I'm going to just lay it just on the edge of my landscape fabric. This will also help hold down the landscape fabric, which is why I didn't put any pins on this side of it. We're gonna put our first one in with our stake. They have plastic stakes for these that you can use. I didn't purchase them because our old barn came with a million of these and they work better in the gravel anyways, because we have very gravelly soil. And then you just go along and put these in every so often to help hold it in place. There you go. So see how it's forming that nice little border? So when these rocks are here, it's gonna help kind of hold these in and keep them in place. So over here along this side, I left this little bit of a divot here where I had basically cut back the grass so that it would be less aggressive on this edge here against the sidewalk. So I didn't want it just growing out from underneath the weed. So I'm going to fill this in with the sand to get it level, just about level with the sidewalk, so then I can continue that border. Okay. Did the compacting walk. Pretty sure that's like the coolest new dance. I'm gonna show up like this. All right, continuing. So I've got the border on and now it's time to get the rest of that gravel unloaded and into the fire pit area. So dark, it's in the bottom. I climbed up to the top. You know there ain't no stopping me. I'm getting faster. I'm going harder.
Okay, so maybe it's pure desperation at this point, but I got this whole area lined. So the fire pit area is all filled with the rock, and I still have quite a bit extra. So I'm thinking I might actually use it over here. I was going to get some crushed gravel to put down below the decking tiles to help with drainage, but I think I might just use that. I actually laid out a couple of squares just to see, and it definitely helps and feels really secure. So let me turn you around, I'll show you. I snapped together these four just so I could like try it out. And honestly, like, they're pretty sturdy that way. It's actually more level here than it is over on the sand. And they feel really secure, like so much, they had so much more give on the sand. So I think I'm gonna go for it. We've got Danielle helping assemble IKEA furniture because I'm so good at it. We've got the hot tub filling. We've got some rock there, a little flower. And I'm getting the rock laid over here so that then I can put down the decking tiles. So these decking tiles are actually pretty cool. So they have the wood on the top, and then on the back they have basically this plastic frame. So there's basically like the female end and the male end, and they snap together. So you just line them up and then see how they snap. So then voila, you just connect them all together like that. This one came out, there we go. So just go through, and then I'm going to start laying it over in the gravel. Done bending over and lifting things. So I've just like hit a wall. Like I hit a wall pretty hard. Yeah, it's cold. It's so cold. I got so cold and so sore, and I just need to stop for the night. So I'm going to stop, but I'm going to go to bed early, get up early, and get this done before I have to pick Lindy up from the airport in the afternoon. There should be enough time because all I need to do is finish putting the deck together and then really just moving everything into place, doing, you know, the little final fun stuff of like setting up the area. All right, checking out for the night. So remember how I said I hit a wall? I guess it wasn't a very sturdy wall, because I'm back out here. I'm stronger. Stronger than I've ever been on fire. Okay, it's getting a bit dark to be filming, so you'll just have to wait until morning to see how it turns out.
Hi friends. Okay, so I am on the way to the airport to get Lindy, and I got everything finished last night, and I'm so glad that I did because it was so cold this morning that even like the extra sand that I had in the wheelbarrow that I was going to go dump this morning, frozen solid. So it definitely paid off, and I'm so glad that I just got it done. So I met my time deadline because I did get the project done in time. But the budget, I was so close, you guys. So the total was $1,377, and my budget budget was $1,200. So honestly, not bad. Now, I did buy some other little miscellaneous things just to kind of stock the canning kitchen because, you know, we were at IKEA, so why not buy a few kitchen gadgets, some little cutting boards, things like that, that we can just keep out there. So when canning season comes, I'm not having to like haul everything out from the house every time we're canning. So I didn't include that because that's just some little extra stuff. But for everything to actually create the space, I came in at $1,377. So that includes the kitchen cart. So it was just about $530. I did get a little discount on that, so that helped. Brought it down to like $513. The little side burner, the little grill burner, they only had one in stock. So we will be adding another one eventually once they come back into stock. It was $175, again, after a little discount. And then I got two, they're actually little like woven pots for plants, but I turned them upside down and put little pop lights in them to use as little hanging lights above the workstation. So each of those was $25. It was a little much, but worth it. I think it adds a lot of charm to the space. And then the deck tiles. The deck tiles I didn't expect to need. I got 17 packs of them, and because it was already paved under where the kitchen workspace is, I didn't end up using, I think, 3 or 4 packs I have left over. But they were $25 each, and I bought 17 of them, and again, I got a little discount, so it came out to be about $406 for those. Not bad overall, and honestly, so much less work than trying to build a deck. And I'm very happy with the way it turned out. It's very sturdy, very easy to walk on, and I really love the look of it. I got 2 yards of the red lava rock, and it was $116. Then there were just some miscellaneous items, so like the little pop lights, the solar lights, landscape fabric, landscape edging. So those little things are kind of what made up the rest of the budget. Overall, I'm really happy with it and the way it turned out for the budget. It's so amazing. But I'm not gonna show it to you until Lindy sees it, because I just don't think that's fair to show you first. So you have to wait, just like she has to wait. So actually, before I left, I made some pizza crusts, and we can cook some pizza over the fire, have a nice bonfire tonight in the fire pit area, and just kind of enjoy the space. Even though it's February and it's chilly, it is sunny and the mountain is out, so it should be a perfect day for it before it starts raining next week. I'm gonna go get Lindy from the airport, and I'm just going to tell her that I'm filming for a regular vlog so that she won't know what she's actually being filmed for. Love like this comes once in a lifetime. For the first time I believe it to be true. All of my friends say I made it! Hi! Welcome home! All the things, all of them.
What things?
You have the things. I just did normal things. Okay, let's try to figure out how to get home.
So go back the way we came into the parking lot. So the light we came from, back the direction we came from to go find the gas we must have passed.
Okay, we can do this.
I can't even make that up.
Let's get gas, and then we can
attempt to
go home. Yes, if we attempt to find that. Gas. Been in the car for 4 hours between driving to the airport and getting Lindy, but we're almost home.
What is that?
What's what?
What did you do? I didn't
do anything.
When did this happen?
I legit cannot get my shoe on.
What the hell? Hold on, I gotta get my shoes on now. I leave for just a little bit. Guys, she did, you guys probably knew about this before I did, huh? She did a thing. What did you do?
I shouldn't be left alone.
No wonder you're tired. It's starting to come together. Did you do the pavers?
I know. It's together.
What the fuck? French toast. Can't say words like that. Can't say words like that.
How did you do it?
Uh-huh.
Look at this. Where did you get this?
IKEA.
Shut up.
We're gonna get a second one that's going to go right here, but they only had one in stock.
What the hell?
Oh, wait.
We got our bins.
Yep, so we've got some stuff for our canning kitchen.
Oh, and it's a full bar. I can't believe this was on concrete.
Yeah, me neither.
That's amazing. Look at this. How did you do this?
I'm very tired.
You have to be. Oh, shit. Oh, this looks so good. Lovely. So I guess we're hot tubbing?
No, we're fire pitting. I have pizza for us.
It's way fun. Glad you like it. Good job. Busy little bumblebee.
I was busy. I'm very sore.
Thanks, that was sore.
I'm sorry.
I finished at 9 o'clock last night.
Maybe.
Cry.